Was geht ab, liebe Basketballfreunde und NBA 2K-Fans da draußen? Einen schönen Start ins Wochenende. Ja, ich werde versuchen, am Wochenende für euch ordentlich Gas zu geben. Ich mache keine Versprechungen, wie viele Folgen, aber es kann durchaus sein, es werden am Wochenende jetzt ein bisschen mehr als unter der Woche. Genau, wir machen jetzt gleich auch weiter. Nur ein kleiner Hinweis, wer vielleicht gerade eben meine Folgen sieht und denkt sich, na, ich hatte schon auch echt Bock auf das Game. Ich veranstalte gerade eben auf Instagram ein großes Gewinnspiel. Es gibt zweimal NBA 2K22, die große Edition, zu gewinnen. Die Anniversary Edition. Und wenn ihr Bock habt, macht einfach mit. Schreibt eure Edition, die ihr wollt, in die Kommentare. Also nicht hier, sondern auf Instagram. Folgt mir dort einfach. Und wer jetzt sagt, ich habe kein Insta, ganz ruhig. Ich habe noch andere, die ich verlosen darf. Das machen wir dann hier in irgendeiner Folge. Vielleicht eine kleine Motivation für den einen oder anderen, dran zu bleiben. Und jetzt geht's weiter. Glückwunsch zum Erreichen des Gipfels als Frischling. Rede mit Ricky über die nächsten Schritte für dich und deine Karriere. Okay, let's go. Ich stelle mir übrigens vor, wie Ricky einfach 24/7 dasteht mit seinem Laptop und ein Kaffee nach dem anderen säuft. Aber ist natürlich bloß ein Spiel.
Big dog walking through. How's it feel to be the MP? YouTube star turned collegiate legend.
Yeah, honestly,
I feel great, bro. Hey, does it feel as great as you thought it was gonna feel when I caught you practicing taking down the net with your little step stool? With
that, oh, you just never gonna let me forget that story, huh, bro?
Nah, man.
Hey, you know what? I respect that.
Hey, for real though. You been thinking at all about next steps?
Bro, always.
That's what I'm talking about. So where's your head at? Because, you know, I got a million ideas about how we could leverage where we're at now, but, you know, I want to know what you're thinking before I push the button on anything.
Reden wir über den NBA Draft? Reden wir über das Training mit Chris Brackley? Reden wir über die G-League? Ich habe genug, um eine Entscheidung zu treffen. Ich bin bald wieder da. Ich habe mir natürlich auch eure Kommentare so ein bisschen durchgelesen und viele wünschen sich, dass wir auch die G-League-Storyline zeigen. Das machen wir aber noch einmal in einem separaten, Story-Strang. Also wir werden das jetzt nicht hier machen, weil ich finde einfach, wer am College war und die Chip gewinnt, der geht in den NBA-Draft und der geht nicht in die G-League. Deswegen machen wir das nochmal an anderer Ort und Stelle. Vielleicht machen wir das sogar im Stream und wir gehen jetzt oder reden wir über den NBA Draft.
Honestly, I'm thinking about the draft, bro. Like the NBA is right around the corner. I can taste it.
As you should be. Your lotto pick. Easy.
So this is the decision you would make if you was me?
I can't tell if you're joking, bro, but yes. You have a chance to be a lotto pick in the NBA. That's gonna make all of our dreams a lot easier to realize. No doubt about that.
Yeah, buddy. Let's do it.
Okay. Also ich kann mir quasi jetzt zu jedem... Wenn ich jetzt hier nochmal draufklick...
Honestly, I'm thinking about the draft, bro. Like the NBA is right around the corner. I can...
Okay, dann kriegen wir nochmal das Gleiche. Reden wir über das Training mit Chris Brackley?
Yo, so real talk, what you think about Chris Brackley?
I mean, he cool. Got a lot of great connections. I mean, I heard good things about his workouts.
Cool, because I'm thinking about training with him. You know, get my draft stock up a bit. You know, get into competition.
Yeah, I mean, that's an option. But it could hurt your draft stock, too. I mean, if you're not playing at the top of your game.
You trying to say, bro, go snitch on me if I'm not good?
Like, I know you kidding, man.
No, I'm not kidding. I'm being serious.
I mean, word does get around, bro. Look, I know you think you're going to kill whatever workout he throws at you, but I just want you to know it goes both ways. I think you should just know what you're getting into before you commit.
I hear you. Okay. Okay, so what you think about the G League?
What about it?
You think it's a good option for us or what?
Are you feeling all right? Bro, you are a guaranteed lotto pick. Why would you even want to go to the G League?
Gee, the G League, they doing good stuff right now. Everybody talking about how they helping players work on their game. Pro tools for the NBA,
okay,
bro.
Yeah. It's a good option for guys that don't want to go to college, sure. But, dude, you went to school. You're draft eligible. Plus, you did so well in college that you are a guaranteed lotto pick.
They can make me better.
Okay, but honestly, in good conscience, I can't advise you to go to the G League.
I hear you. Think about it.
Smart Guy, Ricky sagt genau das, was ich eben auch gerade vorher angesprochen habe. Es macht einfach keinen Sinn. So, ich habe genug, um eine Entscheidung zu treffen. Ich bin bald wieder da.
Yeah, I feel like I got a lot to think about, man.
Yeah, you do. But you also got a lot of people who care about you. Don't feel like you got to make this decision on your own.
Yo, for sure. I appreciate you, bro.
When you're ready to make moves, let me know.
Hey.
Okay, da ist ein Haken dahinter. Das bedeutet, triff eine Entscheidung hinsichtlich deiner Zukunft. Erzähle Ricky, was du als nächstes planst. Ich schau mal ganz kurz hier in meinen MyHub. Okay, da kann ich bloß den Boxscore angucken. Was wir sogar noch mal ganz kurz machen können. Wo sind wir denn? Ah, hier, ganz oben. 37 Punkte, 5, 2. Garantierter Lotteriepick. Also wir müssen eigentlich safe unter den ersten 3 sein mit der Leistung.
You made a decision, haven't you?
You can tell that just by looking at my face, bro.
Man, how long have I known you? Since what? Kindergarten? And you've been making that same stupid face. So come on. Tell me what you want to do.
Also, ich melde mich für den NBA Draft an. Ich will in die G League. Let's go.
Hey, so what you think?
What do I think? I can't believe this, bro.
Hey, bro, you've been gassing me ever since we was in kindergarten, and you can't believe this?
Look, I'm just saying, man, this is huge. This is the NBA, yo. Bro. And it's like, for real, really, for real.
Hey, yo, boy, is it really happening, though?
Man, shut up, bro.
Hey, yo, all right, so what's next, Mr. Manager? What we doing?
Next, I got a lot to do. But I'm gonna need a minute to set everything up. So why don't you just come back in a little bit, and we can talk details.
All right, so what should I do in the meantime?
Don't get hurt.
Funny guy.
No. I'm not playing, MP. If I catch you skateboarding, we gonna have some problems.
All right, Mom. I'll be home before the lights out, too, so I don't get grounded, okay?
You're so funny, bro.
Tausend MVP points. Und jetzt müssen wir reden mit Ricky über die Verpflichtung eines Agenten. Okay, warum machen sie das nicht alles am Stück und machen dann bei den ganzen Quests einen Haken dahinter? Ah, okay, komm mal, weiter geht's.
Yo, yo, you ready to talk agents, bro?
Are you ready, Rick? I'm excited to see what you got, man. You've been over there working like a dog in your little corner.
Hey, do you know how many NBA agents there are? I had to do so much research, bro.
Okay, so who's the front runner? Who are we looking at?
All right, well, I've narrowed it down to 2, and we are looking at Palmer Athletics Agency.
PAA, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
And Berry & Associates.
I don't know, though.
Yeah, they're more up and coming, but they've got a lot going for them. I mean, especially if we're going to branch out into these more ambitious ideas with fashion and music.
Hey, look, tell me about them, bro.
All right, well, I've set up meetings with each agency, all right? So you got to go check these guys out in person and see who you vibe with. I mean, but I can give you a primer.
Yeah, let me hear it.
All right, so PAA is like the gold standard. They've repped anybody who's anybody in the NBA. Hall of Famers, All NBA, you name it.
So why wouldn't we go with them, bro?
Okay, well, let me tell you about Berry & Associates. Look, their founder, Barbara Berry, she's basically a savant. I mean, she started as a musician, became a producer, and now she's an agent, killed it at all 3 levels.
Triple threat, I like that.
Yeah, and they got a good amount of experience repping NBA players, too. I mean, they're just not as big as someone like PAA.
Which means I might get some more personal attention. Hey.
Not only that, bro, but they rep a lot of musicians and people in the entertainment world. I mean, Palmer's pretty much all basketball.
So that can open up a whole nother world for me, bro.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, you get big enough as an athlete, though, you could do the LeBron thing. Work with whoever you want, no matter who your agent is. I mean, look, there's just something about Barbara and her team, though. I mean, they pique my interest. I really feel like she got this unique vision. Like, she could really hook us up with some more outside-the-box kind of things.
So that's the way you lean it, huh?
I honestly think both could do a great job. But, I mean, like any workplace relationship, a lot of it's going to come down to who you're comfortable working with. I mean, so you got to go down and meet them before you make a decision. I mean, just feel them out. See who's a good fit with you personally.
Rick, what do you know about a workplace, bro? 2K Shoes, that's not a boardroom, bro.
All right, hold on. 2K Shoes was hard work, bro. You gonna stop trying to play my achievements.
Okay, look, I know your work ethic. It's amazing, my son, okay?
All right, yeah, well, like I said, I set up meetings with both of them, all right? All you gotta do is go and listen. You can even ask them questions if you feel like participating. You think you can handle that?
Consider it done, my son. Thank you, Rick.
So annoying.
müssen uns einen Agenten rauspicken, ne? Trifft dich mit Kristen Keller und Diana Palmer in der PAA-Agentur. Trifft dich mit Charles Hampton und Barbara Barry bei Barry and Associates. Okay. Da können wir das über hier? Nein, das können wir nicht über das Hub machen, das sehe ich schon. Dann erstmal wieder raus. Um uns mal wieder ein bisschen Zeit zu sparen, habe ich da natürlich jetzt einen kleinen Cut für euch reingehauen. In 200 Metern sind wir beim ersten Ziel. Ja, der ein oder andere schreibt mir in die Kommentare, hey Max, wie kann es sein, dass du so gut bist? Also man muss das auch in Relation setzen. Wie gesagt, ich habe noch die Booster vom Vorbesteller-Bonus, die natürlich definitiv helfen. Und ich weiß von dem... Alter, wir kommen... Und ich weiß von dem einen oder anderen, dass es in der NBA dann wesentlich, wesentlich schwieriger wird. Also deswegen, lasst mich mal noch nicht zu hoch leben. Das kann auch ganz schnell in eine andere Richtung gehen. Und... Ah, nice. Ich habe sogar das 2K-Logo wieder mit rübernehmen können. Okay, das ist auf jeden Fall nice. Habe ich bisher noch nicht so wirklich präsentieren können, weil ich ja kaum hinterherkomme mit den ganzen Videos. Aber jetzt genügend gelabert. Komm rein hier.
Hi, how can I help you?
Hi, I have an appointment with Kristen Kellenher.
Kellenher.
Yeah.
Yes, and you'll be also meeting with Ms. Palmer and of course Mr. Bennett.
Oh, great. He's here already. Cool.
Yeah, he just beat you by a minute. Everyone's on the 21st floor and elevators are right back there.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Jessica,
awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome. Back there.
Habt ihr gesehen, wie sie uns ganz kurz so gemustert hat? So, okay, nice guy. Ja, und natürlich so, ja, die sind übrigens im 20. Stock. Möchten Sie noch ein Aperitif dann hier an der linken Seite? Okay, come on. Rein hier in den Aufzug.
Hey, there he is.
What's up, doing, bro?
I'm good. It's great to finally meet you in person, MP. I'm Kristen.
Diane, nice to meet you all.
No, the pleasure's ours.
Can we get you anything? Coffee, LaCroix?
I'm good.
I think we're ready to just jump in.
Great, good.
So, like I said on the phone, right now we are currently in our home stretch, at least as far as finalizing agencies goes. Right. The missing puzzle piece for me is really just what each team's vision is for MP. Like, I just want to make sure that what you see for him lines up with what we see for him.
Hey, look, Kristen, I just want to know what y'all bringing that we don't have. That's it.
Right, exactly.
Well, those are both very reasonable concerns. When it comes to vision, the good news is this is a science, not an art. The very idea of a superstar athlete was invented inside these walls.
True.
It's what we do. It's in our DNA.
I love that.
Yeah, I do have a question, though.
Of course.
Well, MP and I, you know, we like to think of ourselves as people that do things kind of differently, or outside the norm.
Yeah.
Can either of you guys speak to that?
Do you mind?
Yeah, go ahead.
Any idea how many female heads of sports agencies there are?
No.
Nah.
One. And you're looking at her. So if anybody understands doing things outside the norm, it's us. If anybody knows how to get what they want, regardless of how many people try to tell them no, that's us. When it comes to gender equality, the sports business is stuck in the Stone Age, and we rose to the top because we refused to let anybody else's idea of who or what we should be define us. And that is what we want for you. How many female reps are there repping NBA players right now?
I don't have an exact number, but they could all fit in this room.
You guys get the point. Okay? You live up to your potential on the court, and there is not a single vision you have for yourself that we can't make a reality. Whew. Kristen will be here for you in the day-to-day, and I am always here if you need me. And all you have to do is ball.
That's not bad. How you feeling, big guy?
Nach mehr Details zur Palmer Athletics Agency fragen, unterschreiben. Wir fragen einfach mal nach noch mehr Details.
Yeah, like Ricky was saying earlier, so it's down to you all and another agency, right. Barry and Associates. Mm-hmm. And I'm not trying to put y'all on the spot, but why should we choose y'all versus them?
You guys ever hear of Bay State Law School?
I knew that they had a basketball team named Bay State. I've never heard of a law school, no.
Okay, well. I went to Bay State Law School.
Oh, Kristen, I'm so
don't worry about it. Bay State's a decent law school. I'd say it's pretty good even.
It is.
But it's not Harvard.
Okay.
And it's not Yale. And because of that, it took me much longer to get where I wanted to go in my career than it would have otherwise. You know, I didn't have access to the same connections those blue blood types did. My dad's a mailman from Queens, not some investment banker from Manhattan. So I had to wait my turn. But you, MP, you're a blue chip prospect. And you don't have to go to Bay State. And you don't have to wait your turn. So Barry and Associates, those guys are fine. They're incredible, actually. If you want to quit basketball and start a music career. But in this world, the world of elite professional athletes, they can't compete. We're Harvard and they're Bay State. Now, you don't have to like the game, but you do have to play it. And we play it better than anyone. So how are you feeling?
Ja, die hauen schon ganz schön auf die Kacke, Mann, ey. Was, das sind irgendwelche Spielfiguren und die fangen an, mich hier zu überzeugen, ey. Ja, ich glaube, das reicht jetzt erstmal. Gehen und darüber nachdenken. Oder ich höre mir das andere Angebot auf jeden Fall auch an, nach mehr Details zu hören. Ich glaube, wir sind hier fertig.
Well, it's been great getting to know you, too. You've definitely given me a lot to think about. Well, thank you.
The pleasure's all ours. And look, if you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate to reach out.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, yeah. I'm going to actually stay behind with them and just drill out some finer detail points. But I'll catch up with you.
Man. I copy that.
Have a good day.
Have a good one, ladies.
Take care.
Yeah.
Okay, also das war auf jeden Fall schon einmal überzeugend, muss man sagen. Wisst ihr, was mir dieses Jahr ganz besonders gefällt? Die Charaktere sind alle normal und Ricky ist, glaube ich, der beste Freund, den wir jemals hatten. Keiner, der dir irgendwie auf den Sack geht oder irgendeine crazy Vorgeschichte hat oder möchte gern witzig sein, weil Ricky ist richtiger Ehrenmann. So, jetzt schauen wir hier natürlich auch noch rein. Also ich sehe schon mal hier 20. Stock. Das gibt's hier in der Agentur definitiv. Brauche ich aber auch gar nicht. Lasst reingehen.
Hey.
Good afternoon. How can I help you?
I'm here. I have an appointment with Charles Hampton.
And you must be MP.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, Charles is with your friend Ricky in our East Conference room.
Oh, they're here?
Yeah, I got here about 10 minutes ago. He said he didn't want to keep you waiting.
Ooh, that's my boy. Okay.
Yeah, you can head right back through there. You'll see them in our conference room and you can't miss it.
Great. Thank you.
And my name's Adriana, in case you need anything.
I appreciate that, Adriana. Thank you.
Yeah, enjoy your meeting.
He's got crazy engagement on his YouTube.
Oh, it's been growing every day.
Yeah, people are commenting. He's just got this natural kind of...
What's going on, guys?
It's
MP.
Hey,
how you doing?
There he goes.
How you doing, Charles?
Good to see you, MP.
Am I interrupting something? Y'all sound like y'all having a good conversation.
Definitely good. Nah, man. I was just telling him about an album launch party I was at with The Weeknd in Paris.
Word?
It's wild, man.
Dope.
Yeah, it's a long story. But, you know, I know you're a busy man. We should just get into it.
Yeah, let's get into it. I'm excited to hear what you got to say.
Oh, you just gonna represent yourself now. All right, no, if that's what we're doing.
Come on, shut up. Just let the man talk.
My bad. Sorry about my client.
You guys ready to hear my pitch?
Yes.
Please, continue.
Okay. Well, I'd like to tell you guys two things you know, two things you don't know. Yeah? All right, let's start with what you know. You're a remarkable talent. Someone with a chance to do something very special in the league.
I'm with you so far.
Second, and most importantly, or I should say, due in large part to your boy Ricky over here, you got a very large, very quantifiable, and therefore very monetizable fan base, and they'll hang on your every word whether or not you ever step foot on an NBA court.
Hey, did you know that this dude didn't even want to start a YouTube page? Right. Like, hey, look, in the beginning, wow. It was like pulling teeth with him.
Let the man finish talking.
Well, listen, let's talk about what you don't know. First, you have the potential to make more money off the court than any player in the history of the NBA.
I like that.
Second, and most importantly, you can accomplish this outside of a larger corporate structure, answering only to yourselves, your vision.
Okay, but what about somebody like Nike, right? Are you saying that we wouldn't be working with them?
No. It's not that you wouldn't work with Nike or Gatorade or whoever, right? But the whole goal is to position you as a trailblazing icon. Mm. Because nobody else has your story, MP.
Yeah.
And we know how to make the most of it. Okay. You guys know E-40?
E-40, yeah. Dude's a legend, man.
Well, listen, growing up in the Bay, he's a hero of mine. And not just because of his music, which is ridiculously good.
Right.
But because the dude did it on his own terms. The guy started a record label when that was not something rap artists did. He's inspired me since day one. I mean, truth be told, he's the reason why I became an agent. Because I wanted to help artists establish their unique vision, their truths, no matter what the outside world told them was possible. That's what you need. That's what we can do for you.
I'm not gonna lie, that all sounds great, Charles. What'd you think, MP? Where's your head at?
Okay, so right now it's down to you guys and PAA.
Okay.
So why are you a better fit than them?
Who are you working with over there?
Kristen Kelleher and Diane Palmer.
Yeah.
They're very accomplished and respected, and for good reason. But you know what they do over there is more of a traditional corporate vibe. I mean, it's everything you'd expect a top sports agency to be, which is good and bad.
Good and what do you mean by that? Bad.
Well, you know, they never tell you what I'm gonna tell you. Which is that you can have an incredibly lucrative career, whether or not you ever step foot on an NBA court. Now, Diane have a heart attack if she heard me say that. For them, it's NBA or bust, right? But they don't know how to carve out the type of career that you and Ricky see for yourselves. Mm. That all starts with Barbara.
Barbara, yes. Where is she? You know, I thought she was going to be here today.
Yeah, she had a last minute thing. She sends her apologies.
We can live with that. That's cool.
You guys know her story?
A little bit. I'm not too familiar with it, though.
Well, I'll keep it short. She got her start in a girl group. You guys know SV3?
Sure.
No.
Well, you know, so it's the typical boy band girl group thing.
Okay,
you know,
yeah,
label finds a four-pack of talented singers, tosses them together, marketing defines their look, and, you know, off they go.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, until they're not popular anymore, and then they get dropped.
So you do know the story.
Well, I mean, he said he didn't know. I always do my research.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, you know, after the whole SV3 thing, Barbara, she just decided she was going to define her career. Okay. Nobody else. So she pivoted, you know, went behind the boards, became one of the most in-demand producers in the game. I mean, she's got like, what, 20 number one singles to her name?
That's right.
That's dope. Yo, that story is dope. And you knowing it? Ricky.
Barbara's a genius, man. I mean, we're here for a reason.
Yeah, like Ricky said, Barbara's a visionary. But music wasn't enough, you know, she got restless. She decided, hey, why not become one of the world's top entertainment agents? And she became enamored with this new breed of athlete that isn't content to just shut up and dribble. Yeah. Listen, anybody can get you a meeting with Nike, MP.
Okay.
Just be good at basketball. Nike will find you. But what you might not get at PAA, or at least not nearly as soon, are all the other things that we talked about. Now, those are the things that are going to set you apart. And we excel at those things. We can help you get them. What are we thinking?
Also, ich muss sagen, am Anfang war ich eigentlich direkt, ja, ich gehe zu Barry. Jetzt habe ich beide Parteien gehört und es ist doch gar nicht so close, wie ich zu Beginn dachte. Aber ich denke, dass diese Storyline hier eventuell interessanter ist, auch abseits vom Court. Und wenn ich auch an so Ikonen wie Allen Iverson, Michael Jordan und so weiter und so fort denke, wie groß ihr Einfluss halt auch eben abseits vom Basketball war, auch wenn der Main-Fokus natürlich schon immer auf der NBA lag, dann denke ich, gehe ich hier mit Barry and Associates und ja, ich muss gar nicht wieder zurück zur anderen Agentur, wir unterschreiben hier.
You know, Charles, Ricky and I, we always talking about using sports to set up other stuff. My music, my fashion, like that's the type of career I see for myself, man. Just groundbreaking as a new athlete, that's what I want.
So do we have a deal?
Hey, you know what, Charles? Man, we got a deal.
That's what's up.
We got a deal, man.
That's what's up.
So what are we doing? What happens next?
Well, look, man, I'm going to hang back with Ricky. We'll hash out some details.
Cool.
You know, go do you, man. Go work out, hey, watch film, whatever it is superstars do.
It's a pleasure. I'm looking forward to working with you, man. Ricky, I catch you later,
yeah,
we're
going
to
do some big things, MP.
Charles, it ain't over, man. It's just getting started.
Nah, we're just getting started, my friend.
So let's talk, Charles. What kind of percentages we looking at?
Oh, well, listen, man. I got some branding ideas.
Okay, die Entscheidung ist gefallen. Puh. Nimm an einer Draft-Watch-Party in deinem Apartment teil. Rede mit Ricky über deine Teilnahme am Draft-Combine. Wir schauen noch einmal ganz kurz auf Sandy, was da abgeht. Mein Bro MP kämpft bis ganz nach oben gegen das System. Habe gesehen, dass er bei Barry and Associates unterschrieben hat, anstatt bei einer dieser 0815 Sportagenturen. Mega. Barbara Barry, war die nicht mal in einer Girl Group? Weed Times 3 oder so, wird MP jetzt etwa Sänger. Weird Flex, aber okay. Ich würde sagen, dein Bild ist Weird Flex. Malika, und danach geht's weiter. MPs Leute haben heute eine komische Entscheidung bekannt gegeben. Anscheinend hat er Barry and Associates als seine Agentur verpflichtet. Seinen Internet-Hintergrund kennt ja jeder. Vielleicht glaubt er, dass er daraus mit dieser Agentur noch mehr Kapital schlagen kann. Malika, du hast es verstanden. So, das war's, Freunde, mit dieser Episode. Wir haben uns für eine Agentur entschlossen. Das nächste Mal Draft Watch Party, Draft Combine. Ob der Draft dann schon ansteht, I don't know. Lasst euch einfach überraschen. Ich lasse mich überraschen, weil ich nach wie vor auch spoilerfrei bin, was die Story anbelangt. Und ansonsten schönes Wochenende. Wie gesagt, es kommen definitiv ein paar Folgen. Danke fürs Reingucken. Lasst mir einen Daumen nach oben da. Bis zum nächsten Mal, Freunde. Ciao.